make Mel mad. Because we discovered on this program a few months ago, there's nothing more fun than when Mel is mad. And so I'm going to try and do that by just, I almost feel like this is cheating. It's too easy. But as I have done all my research for this draft next week, Mel, I have come to the following conclusion. There are not one, not two, but three running backs that should go in round one next Thursday night in this draft, in this order: Najee Harris, Travis Etienne, and then Javonte Williams from North Carolina. Mel, what do you think?
I was smiling, Greeny, because I knew you were going to tick me off, and I love to get fired up about something. And you know, so I knew you were going to bring something crazy to the table here. Running backs in the first round, I don't get it. History tells us you can find them from the second round on. History tells us why take one in the first round. You don't need to. Look at the teams that win big in the NFL. Was it a first round running back that they drafted? That they drafted that keyed that Super Bowl win or that run through the playoffs? No. And I think when you look at Najee Harris and Travis Etienne and Javonte Williams, are they as good as J.K. Dobbins, Jonathan Taylor, and DeAndre Swift last year? I can say no, they're not. And all those guys went in the second round. They had really good rookie years, but they were not first-round picks. Clyde Edwards-Helaire at 32 to Kansas City was the only first-round pick. No, no, no. Mistake, mistake, mistake. Three in a row there, Greeny, if you take a running back in round one. But early second round, Jacksonville, the Jets, Atlanta, Miami, in the second, that sweet spot for running backs, round two, that's where you start pulling a trigger on a running back.
Boy, am I hoping this happens next Thursday night, guys, as I bring Lewis and Booger back into the conversation here. I just hope it happens just to see Mel's reaction. But let me make my case, and I'm going to get into this a little more on radio. But do I have Lewis still? I'd like to bring Lewis in on this thought.
I'm here.
Here's my belief, and I hate saying this because it's so totally unfair to them. But I believe you take the running back in the first round because you get the fifth year. And then you don't ever, under any circumstances, consider giving the running back a second contract. The lot in life of a running back is to get drafted, to get used up, and then to be moved on from. But if you look at early in their careers, the impacts that Saquon Barkley, Ezekiel Elliott, guys like that can have immediately on teams, if they're that kind of special, I do think it is worth the first-round pick. The mistake people make is when they sign them to the second contract. That's where it almost always runs into a brick wall. Lewis, what do you think?
Yeah, you know, I mean, I think when you're talking about unique players, I think that's the key. Is the guy unique? Is the guy have some kind of ability that really you feel as though when you look at the history of running backs, he brings something to the table that other running backs just simply have not? And look, when Ezekiel Elliott came out, there were many who believed his ability to affect all three downs, both run and pass, was something that was unique. So I understood why Dallas took him. But I don't think the running backs in this class really affect the game on all three downs to that degree. So I'm with Mel in this case. I think it's case by case. I don't think overall you can say that no running back deserves to go in the first round. I think it is an individualized type of thing. I think they can have an immediate impact. I do agree you make mistakes when you sign them to second contracts, especially if they have a lot of tread on their tires. It's just a case by case situation.
What do you think, Bug?
Yeah, when you look at a guy who's a pure running back, but what I would tell Mel is don't think about him as a running back. Think about whoever it is as a weapon, somebody that's going to carry the football and also catch 80 or 90 balls. You talk about Kyle Pitts, that he's one of one. And I'm not saying that there's one in this draft, but if there's a running back that comes along that is a weapon, a guy that is a three-down player like Lewis is talking about, a guy that can catch you 70 or 80, 90 balls but can also run between the tackles, Mel, you're going to have to come off of this running back in the first round thing, guy. You're going to have to open your mind up. They're not running backs. They're football players. So don't put people in positions, Mel. Come on.
Come on, Mel.
That's fine. Alvin Kamara was the third-round draft choice. To me, you look at a Demetric Felton, UCLA, and Michael Carter, North Carolina. Boog, you can find those. Hey, I'm with you. And one thing Lewis said about they deserve. Yeah, there are guys that deserve to be first-rounders. I'm not arguing that point. I just wouldn't take them. I said if the grade early on was in line and I had that head coach saying I got to have them, maybe you say, okay, if the grade is way up there, fine. But I'm not taking a running back. You don't
sure.
need to. And I like these guys. I think they deserve to go. I'm just not taking them on my football team.
Thank you for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.